need my name and spelling? Okay. My name is Pastor Mark, M-A-R-K, J, period, Powell, P-O-W-E-L-L. I'm the chief executive of a newly formed group called All Lives Matter. It's going to be incorporated here in Indiana in honor of Jessica Doty Whitaker. And so I'm here with the family today. We're going to have our time with you and their opportunity to express to the community that they need help finding the assassin of Jessica. And this is a story that has been heard all around the world. And I was just on my way here today, I was talking with a friend of mine in Los Angeles, and she had just heard about this, read about this today. So it's nationwide, it's worldwide, and it's important that the folks in Indianapolis, the police department, and citizens get a chance to be an active part in finding the perpetrator of this horrific act. And we'll have a prayer service then afterwards. But I just wanted to start out here today with a quote from Thoreau. He said, "Every blade in the field, every leaf in the forest lays down its life in its season as beautifully as it was taken up." And the reason we're here today, the reason the family's here today, is to talk about this beautiful life of this wonderful 24-year-old mother of a 3-year-old fiance who had her whole life in front of her. And because she said all lives matter, she was assassinated. And that needs to be addressed, not only by the community at large, but by the assassin, that person is found, those who were with him are found, and prosecuted to the fullest extent of the law. So I, without any further ado, I just wanted to start with the family members, and for Leni Doty Whitaker, who's mother of Jessica.
Hi, I just wanted to say, I want to catch her killer. She was not supposed to leave this earth when she did. She was a mother. She was a daughter. She was a sister. She was a cousin. She had a family that loved her very much. And any strangers that ever met her adored her. She had a heart of gold. And this wasn't supposed to happen to her. Especially over something so racial, because she was not a racial person. I want her home, I want her back, and I know that can't happen. And explaining this to her son is the hardest thing in the world. As bad as my heart breaks, it breaks even more for him. And I don't know what else I can say. But she had a family that loved her very much.
Maybe just ask the folks to help.
And I beg and plead, somebody come forward. Somebody seen something. Let's bring justice for Jessica, because her murder shouldn't go in a file that's unsolved. There was as many people here that seen it. They had a small child with them. It's heartbreaking. I just want somebody to come forward and say, hey, I know who did this. Or even the killer come forward and say, hey, I did this. We don't need the negativity that comes with it, but we do need her killer found.
Thank you, Mom.
Thank you. Oh, sorry. Did you want to say
something? Yeah, I'm all babbled. Do you want to do
Jenny?
I don't think I need them. My tears will hit the ground like her blood did.
The sisters of...
I'm her aunt.
Her aunt? And if you would just say your name and probably spell it out for them. Some of the family members want to come this way? Just to kind of be in back here. Great.
All right,
ready?
Read a poem that she had sent to me probably around a year ago. She was a beautiful poet. She loved to write, loved to laugh and sing and dance. She was such a happy person. Together entombed we the floor we stood on as pain fills the atmosphere, giving lack of trust to inhale, exhaling rage, leaving us together but invisible to another, overwhelmed with loneliness. In search of a single flame and hope to destroy the darkness, to light the path that would lead back to what was, to feel the warmth of disappear. She was a beautiful poet.
Thank you, Tisha.
Mom, over.
Rhonda, did you want to say something? Rhonda's Jessica's grandmother.
Jessica was somebody really special, not just to our family, but she worked in home health care, and she was just as important to those people that we've gotten notes from. What a wonderful person she was, and how thankful they were that she was taking care of their loved ones. We celebrated everything together, birthdays, holidays, and she's going to be missed. Sometimes I wonder how we're going to keep going on, but I, like my daughter, want this violence to stop. That person needs to know what it feels like to every breath you take, you see her, you hear her, you laugh at things she used to say to you, and she was truly loved by all.
Anyone else? Michael, do you want to say something? This is Michael Henley, H-E-N-L-E-Y, was there at the evening of the assassination.
Well, I just want to say, I hope you're found. I know you're probably going to see this. I hope it eats at you every night. He took a mom, a fiance, a sister and a brother. Justice for Jess.
Jose, did you want to say anything? Jose's fiance, Jessica.
I would like to say.
If we just work on getting the canal safer for everybody so it won't happen. Get more cameras, more police patrol, something. She was a wonderful person, as everybody already heard. We just hope we can just get justice. That's all we want is justice. That's all we can ask for is just justice now. Thank you.
Anyone else? You have any questions?
Just with the family, have you guys been in contact with IMPD, like detectives keeping you guys
Yes, I do. Okay. Have a detective on the case, and he keeps me updated on everything he's doing.
Okay.
Before the lost photographs were released, he called me and told me that they had got some surveillance video from one of the surrounding businesses. And he called me and told me he was going to release it so that I wasn't bombarded with it. But we do have a detective on the case. Anybody knows anything, call Crime Stoppers. I was told every lead that is sent to Crime Stoppers is totally investigated to make sure it's a valid lead. And I'm just hoping somebody will come forward. And another thing that needs to happen is this canal needs to be made safe. You know what? I have come down here all hours of the day or night with all of my children. And we never had no worries walking down here. And Jessica absolutely loved walking down here. It became her and Jose's spot as well as our spot. And it was something we could
down here in the wintertime. When it's cold, she'll come down.
It was something we could do as a family, and that was important to her, spending time with her family. I think that's why she never went and moved away, so she could stay close to us. But this place is not safe. I don't feel safe coming down here like I did last summer, the summer before. But now it's just, it needs to be made safe because this is a beautiful place. This canal is beautiful to walk around. But it's not going to remain that way with it, all the violence going on. She had a loving heart, a very loving heart. And I think to do her justice, we need to make this a safe place to walk, a safe place for the kids to come and see the ducks, see at the fountains, play at the park. I mean, there's lots of things to do down here as a family. And it doesn't matter if it's 12 o'clock in the afternoon or 3 o'clock in the morning. You should My nickname is Leanie, but everybody, but my name is Arlena.
Okay. So what do you want to go by? You want to go by Leanie?
Arlena.
Can you spell that for me?
It is A-R-L-E-N-A.
Okay, and last name?
Jody.
Okay, got it. Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you guys.
Thank you guys.
Thank you guys for hearing our story.
Yeah. Just to wrap it up, just want to say once again that we're here for unity in the community, that it's not Black Lives Matter or White Lives Matter or Brown Lives Matter, Red Lives Matter. God says all lives matter. And that's what we're about, and that's what I hope the assassination of this young lady, her death will not be in vain, because we learned this lesson as not only as a community here in Indianapolis, but also throughout this country and throughout the world, that we're all in this together. It's the unity of our humanity that counts. And we have the opportunity to stop this mindless menace of violence, as Robert Kennedy once said, here in this town, when Martin Luther King was assassinated. So we need to have that spirit again here in this country, of unified efforts to make our lives better. And I just thank each and every one of you for being here today to help spread that message and to grieve with this family and to grieve the loss of a young life that should be here with us today. So thank you very much.
You know, it's like my uncle told me yesterday. He said he was talking about him and his sister.